안녕하세요. Hello, I am Brendan and I'm from the United States.
I was in the United States Marine Corps from 2009 to 2013. There's a lot of hard part. There's nothing really easy in any of it. From the beginning until you leave, there's always going to be hard parts. I think mainly it's all mental. If you're not mentally strong to become a United States Marine, then you shouldn't do it. But mainly Marine Corps is really mentally tough.
They feed you. They gave you a good portion of food to eat. But half the time I really didn't eat at all because someone would do something stupid and take away our food privileges. For example, we all get our food. Someone starts talking, our food goes thrown away.
If someone talks while they're eating, everyone throws their food away and they go out and do more training because that's just how the Marine Corps is. If one person messes up, everyone messes up. Everyone pays for it. Water, lots and lots of water.
Water gets the cure for anything. If you're sick in the Marine Corps, if you're sick, drink water. If you're tired, drink water. If you're hungry, drink water. If you're thirsty, drink water. If you're feeling like you're going to die, drink water. If your feet hurt, drink water. Water is like the cure for everything in boot camp in Marine Corps.
That's like the Koreans Navy SEALs, underwater demolition team. I mean, I studied a lot about military and the history. Every country has their own special team. So I do know that Korea has their own special force. I always wanted to know who were they, and they're the UDT.
That sounds about right, yeah.
That's standard Marine Corps training. That's just the minimum. Like, that's what we did, like, first week of going into the Marine Corps. We were up running, exercising PT. We're up for a whole week before we actually got to our actual unit. We didn't sleep at all for a week. We were up for a whole week. We didn't know what day it was, what time it was, nothing. Pretty sure it's really similar.
겨우 한숨 돌리게 된 점심시간. 보트 젓는 페달을 미리 깨끗하게 씻어놓은 데는 이유가 있었다. 페달을 식판으로 사용하기 때문이다. 숟가락도 따로 없다. 지옥주의 오랜 관행이다.
아, this is basically hazing.
오늘 훈련을 심하게 해야 돼. 훈련을 좀 힘들게 해가지고 밥이 별로 안 먹고 싶습니다.
He lost his appetite. Really? No. There's no way. I'm sorry. Training can be hard, but food is the motivator during boot camp, Hell Week especially. Like, only time we don't get an appetite or anything to eat is if someone screws up and actually just we can't eat at all because we had thrown food away. I've never heard of that ever in my life. With something being so hard, I just, oh, forget eating. I just starve and die, you know? I never heard of that ever, but meh.
밥이 별로 안 먹고 싶습니다.
턱걸이 훈련은 매일 점심 먹기 전 실시된다. 합격하면 바로 식당행이지만 불합격자들은 팔굽혀펴기를 다 마치고 나서 그것도 철봉 위에서 먹어야 한다. 그나마 이렇게 철봉 끝이라도 차지할 수 있으면 다행이다.
This is not training. This is hazing. They're effing with these guys. I honestly don't see how this is going to be beneficial to the war. What is this going to do? Honestly, I'm not going to be sitting on a pull-up bar eating food with my rifle. It's not practical. They're screwing with these guys. It's maybe a mental exercise. However, this is not practical. Why would I sit on pull-up bars eating my food? These are mind games. They're screwing with them to see who's going to break. That's it.
그나마 이렇게 철봉 끝이라도 차지할 수 있으면 다행이다. 불합격자가 많은 날은 철봉 가운데서 고개를 해야 한다.
As a United States Marine, I have been exposed to the art of mind games. So this hurts mentally more than it hurts physically. However, yeah, this is not training. It may help a little bit, maybe like muscles, but these are mind games. This is not actual training because it's not practical. But I respect the mind games. It's really funny watching it now.
많은 날은 철봉 한 가운데서 고개를 해야 한다.
오.
지사병들이 특식 준비에 한창이다. 생도들에겐 마지막 만찬이다. 먹지 않고 버티는 4박 5일의 생식주가 시작되기 때문이다.
Well, that's not bad.
지금까지 다진 체력을 바탕으로 정신력과 인내심을 기르기 위한 훈련.
Five days without food? That's really not that bad. That's not bad. Five days without food is not that bad.
위한 훈련이다.
좀만 기다려, 좀만. 잠깐만. 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 하나도 없나? 오케이, 오케이. 들어, 이거. 20번.
이들을 지배하고 있는 것은 우선 생존해야 한다는 일념이다.
오, 나이스. 아답트 어치브 오버컴.
아답을 배만해?
맞습니다.
맛이 어때?
맞습니다. 담백합니다. 잠 못 자고 일단 먹는 게 중요하니까 잠 못 자는 거 어차피 참을 수 있습니다. 근데 배고프니까 도저히 참을 수 없었습니다.
He has a point. These guys can't sleep and they have to go without food, but they didn't say you can't catch your own food. I respect that, you know. He's right. They're absolutely right. It's about overcoming. So, I respect him. Yeah.
생식주는 생도들에게만 해당된다.
Only Chinese. Okay. Oh, what a dick. Oh, really? Oh.
그것을 철저하게 이용한다.
Oh, he's just being a dick right now. Like he's really just that's a douche move. Like that's a douche move. I mean, come on. The guys are starving. Like you're like, "Oh, look at my samgyeopsal. So yummy. Do you want a bite? Oh, you can't because you're training. I'm not." That's the mind games because you have to smell. You already smell it, so you're like, oh, I'm hungry. Now you have guys taunting you like, oh, you know what? I got this delicious food here. You have to suffer. Funny thing about being a Navy SEAL, anytime you can make the training stop, but then you're always known as a quitter. So that's a pretty douchey move. It's basically like a little kid with candy, like, I got this popsicle, you don't have it. Like, I'm like, dude, like, these are already suffering enough, you know? It happened before, like, when I was in boot camp, they did the same thing with us. Like, oh, this is good. Suck for you guys. You know, I'm like, oh, what a douchebag. You know, when these guys are sitting here, they literally have to sit here in like an Indian style and just like watching these guys is like having a feast and they're sitting there hungry.
Yeah. 물어 생도들을 앞에 앉혀놓고 유혹을 한다. 고기한 점 먹고 훈련을 포기하느냐 아니면 계속 견디느냐를 선택하라는 것이다.
I told you with the SEAL training, you can make it stop. If you give in and eat that piece of meat, your training is done. You're no longer going to become a Navy SEAL. You gave up.
죽고 싶어. 뼈 떨어 먹고 싶어. 먹고 싶은 것도 못 먹고. 아예 생식주가 아닌데 진짜 치워준 거야. 맨날 뛰고 훈련 받고 그러니까 힘들잖아.
빵 일고 아래 보너스로 오징어를 주겠습니다. 오징어. 알겠어요. 알겠어요. 대신 자기 몸 안 다치게 최선을 다합니다. 준비! 땅!
등대까지 왕복 달리기. 팀장이 들어오는 등수에 따라 건빵 개수가 달라진다.
I did this run, so I can imagine what these guys are going through. And that sucks, because you have to run at a certain pace with a full combat load. It's not easy.
Oh. 1등은 4팀 팀장.
No.
팀원들을 위해서 등대까지 왕복 1.4km를 완전 군장으로 전력 진수했다.
Yeah! Yeah! If in boot camp or anything, you win, you're the hero. I know he got a lot of respect.
Yeah. 4팀은 건빵 10개에 보너스로 오징어 반 마리까지 받았다.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
자, 이거 2개다.
오징어 다리는 2등을 한 팀에게 돌아갔다.
자, 나머지 그래가지고 체크.
아, that's not enough.
맛있네.
아, 맛있습니다. 우리 어떻게 줄 안 먹는다.
그런데 이곳으로 얼마나 영양 보충이 될까?
자기 몸에 존재해 있는 잠재력이 다 있습니다. 저희는 그 잠재력을 키워주는 데 목적이기 때문에 한 2-3일 동안 굶었지만 그래도 몸에 자기가 쓸 수 있는 힘이 남아 있습니다.
That is amazing. It's inspiring. It's a funny story. My mind is a strong weapon if you know how to use it. It can be weak or strong. Fun story. It was when I was going through Hell Week, the last day. I was walking with my whole pack, and then next thing you know, my pack broke, and it started choking the crap out of me, just choking me. And the drill instructor saw that. He didn't help me. He didn't do anything. I'm choking, walking, trying to keep the pace. It's going fast pace. And next thing you know, I just like grabbed the pack, tie it with a little strap to make it sit somewhat up. And he came up to me and was like, you see that? That's the mind. Then you know you don't quit. You find a way, always. Remember that. And he walked forward. I'm like, So even though you have no energy or anything, the mind is a strong weapon. How you use it is how you succeed or fail. Today, I reviewed and watched UDT, Underwater Demolition Team. Some of the training was a little bit borderline hazing, but I really like it and respect the UDT. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Also, if you guys recommend anything, comment below, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.